Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1973, automatically add daily entries for running total. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gill, and today's question via Twitter from John. John has three columns. He has daily entries and total, and he says every day, I'd like to add the cost of the items of these things into daily entries. It will immediately add those values to the pre-existing total and then will remain blank for entry for the next time. All right. And I tweeted back to John. I said, hey, you know, it's immediately as possible, but it's lousy if you ever make a mistake because it knocks out undo. So I'm going to show you two ways, immediately and the way that I would do this. All right, to have these entries immediately get added over here, we start out first, make sure that the workbook is saved as an xlsm. So file, save as. And you have to choose xlsm or xlsb. The default xlsx will not work. Then we're going to go into VBA, so that's Alt F11. If you don't see the Project Explorer, press Control R for the Project Explorer. We're on Sheet 1. I'm going to right click and say View Code. Then two drop downs. From the top left drop down, only one choice, Worksheet. They automatically put in selection change. I want to change that to be change. In other words, every time that we change something on this worksheet, we're going to run this macro code. All right, and what we do, they tell us what cell or cells were just changed. I check and see if it's an intersection of the place where we're going to be entering data. In this case, it's B2 to B15. In your case, if you had larger or smaller, you would change that. If they change something outside of that range, then we don't do anything. Otherwise, for each cell that they changed, we're going to say that the cell 1 column to the right of this cell is going to be equal to whatever was there before plus the value we just typed, and then clear out the original cell. Now, before we change anything in the worksheet, we have to turn off events and then turn them back on. All right, so this little bit of code, file, close, and return to Microsoft Excel, will do what I think John was wanting to do. So here, eggplant, we used to have 4. I type in 3. Press enter and we get 7. These two, we both had 9. I type in 2 and then control enter and they both get incremented by 2. All right, so I can handle the situation where they select multiple items. But here's a problem. Let's say that I want to add 1 kale and I accidentally type 11 and then press enter. Oh shoot, undo? No, there's no undo. The having a selection change macro, or actually any macro, wipes out undo. Now you have to go back and say, oh, what did I do? I meant to enter 1, I entered 10 or 11, so I have to do minus 10, right? What a horrible pain that is to do. So what I would prefer, I'm going to come here to method 2, is tell the people that they have to go through and enter all their values for the whole day. And then if you make a mistake, oh, that should have been 2, all right? Then when that's completely done, we're going to move those entries over to the total. Here's how you do that. Alt F11, insert a module. All right, so now we're on module 1. Simple little macro, I call it sweep for each cell in B2 to B15. Again, you would change that. Add the value in this cell to the value that was to the right of us, and then clear the whole range. How do we get them to run that macro? Just insert any shape. I like the rounded rectangle. Type a caption there. We can center, maybe even make it a little bit larger. And then right click, assign macro, and we're assigning it to the sweep macro. All right, so now here's all these entries. Choose add daily entries to total, and they all get moved over at once. That way you can make sure that you didn't make any mistakes. So can we do it immediately? Yes. You can, but it'd be a lot safer, in my opinion, to have a macro that would do it all at one time. All right, so hey, I want to thank John for sending that question in. And hey, if you're interested in learning more about VBA, check out this book by Tracy and myself. We'll walk you up the VBA learning curve. Hey, we'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.